tell about when you made your first car purchase, a 1960 T-Bird?
Well, I was played in 1960 was my first full year in professional baseball. I played in Eau Claire, Wisconsin, and my brother Frank, who was playing for the Braves or in their organization, that time he was just in their organization, he was playing in Vancouver. He was living in Milwaukee because he had been playing for the Braves. So on the way down from Eau Claire, I stopped in Milwaukee. I figured I'd hang out with my brother for the last month of the season. And I get called into the office and they said, we're going to activate you for the final month of the season, which was a big thrill for me. I had two at-bats, I got a hit and I struck out. But Bud Selig was supplying not all the players with cars, but a couple of them, and my brother was one of them. So we went out to see Bud, and I wanted to buy a car, my first purchase, you know.
He was a car dealer.
He was a car dealer. I mean, his family had was Knippel Selig Ford, and you know, he had all these T-Birds on the lot, you know, 1960. So it was, you know, we're talking about October of 60. So they're already getting the 61s revved up, you know, and I just liked what the 60 T-Bird looked like. And I bought a black T-Bird with a red interior, and it was a big thrill, unfortunately. And, you know, the following spring, when my brother and I went to spring training, we had an automobile accident and totaled the car. We were lucky that, you know, we didn't have any major injuries on that one.
Well, and you had a relationship, though, with Selig, essentially, ever since?
It's been close. I mean, he knew me as a teenager. I met him even before that. I met him in 1956, 57, when my brother's first year in the big leagues and the first World Series in 57. So he met me as Frank's kid brother at that time. A year or so before I decided to retire from managing, he said, you know, when it's time for you not to do this anymore, he says, I've got an idea for you for a job.
And how big of an adjustment was that for you?
You know, it was a big adjustment because,
you've been, with the exception of the 5 years in broadcasting, been 162 game season since you were in your 20s.
I know, and you know, it was always like brand new. It was always brand new because you always had different players. You know, whether you were a player or a manager, it was always something the next year that was like a carrot being dangled for you. But you know, going into the commissioner's office, I said, "You sure I can do this job?" He said, "Oh yeah, you can do the job." And because I had opportunities to go broadcast, and I just didn't feel I wanted to do that. And I'm so close to baseball. I felt I wanted to do something significant in a some kind of position. And Bud asked me to come on board.